Hello there, beautiful people. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Jason Yohungweme, and if you're stopping by for the first time, welcome to my channel. I film about life in the Nigerian university. I also film about faith. If you enjoyed today's video, please like, subscribe, and share with a friend. Thank you for stopping by. So now let's jump straight into the video. So today's video is going to be about 10 random things I wish I knew before getting into the Nigerian university. To be honest, nothing can really prepare you for the Nigerian university. Even if someone is selling a manual about things you should expect in the Nigerian university, that manual will not be enough. The book will not be enough to tell you about how you should get prepared for the Nigerian university. But I just want to share 10 things I just wish I knew before getting there. So the first thing I wish I knew before getting into the university in Nigeria is the fact that for my first few weeks or few months in school, what am I saying, for my first year in school, everybody would call you fresher. As time goes on, it could reduce, maybe when you get familiar with people, but for those first few weeks in school, they will not care to know what your name is. As long as they know you're a journey just come in school, they are going to call you fresher. I don't know if this applies to all schools, but in my school, this is what they do regularly. Immediately they know, this one is a journey just come, your name automatically turns to fresher. They don't care if your name is Rachel, your name is Johnson, whatever your name is, your name automatically turns to fresher. Then they also do this thing where you know you're a new student and you're not familiar with everywhere in school. Then you ask for directions, like, oh, hey, I'm going to this place, I'm going to that place. Once they know that, this person is a new student, they will give you wrong directions just so you could go around the school and get to know the school. You get, so that you could get to know the school. So the fact that they know you're a fresher, they would give you wrong directions. If where you're going to is in front of you, they can tell you, oh, you're going the wrong way, go back, go this way, go that way. For the fact that you're a fresher, you'll just be walking up and down. So if you're a new student in a Nigerian university, I would advise you, ask your fellow colleagues, your fellow freshers, for directions. Don't just ask a random person on the road. Though there are some nice people that would actually tell you the right directions. Like, I was privileged to always meet nice people and be like, oh, I'm going to this place. There was even this day, I met this guy, like, oh, please, I'm going to this place. And I was like, oh, no problem, I'll take you there. That's not where I'm going to, but I'll take you there. So there are actually some nice people, but there are just some people that I don't know where they came from. They just derive pleasure doing things like that. They'll tell you, oh, you're going the wrong way, you have to go back and maybe get to school gates before you even go to where you're going to. So that's the first thing I wish I knew before getting into the university in Nigeria. Second thing I wish I knew before getting into the university is the fact that for my first few weeks in school, I'm going to waste a lot of money. Like, it happened to me, and I'm sure it happened to a whole lot of people. You're going to print one course form, you're going to print something, print another thing. To be honest, like, it was just so, I really regretted wasting so much money, because you would print something, maybe you print it in black and white, you get the level advisor, he'll tell you, no, you need it in colored, or you get to the admin office and they'll tell you, no, you need it in black and white. It was so irritating and frustrating. And the worst part is the fact that those business center people, or the people that help you print and all, they don't care. It's their business. See, if you want to print a million copies, they are ready, they are even happy. Though some people, some nice people that, you know, they are really nice, they'll tell you that, oh, you don't need this, you don't need that. But on an average, they don't care. Just print and be going. It's not their business. So they won't tell you that, oh, you don't need this, oh, you don't need that. So get ready, pack plenty money, tell your dad, tell your mom that, I need money, because for the first few weeks you're just going to be printing. You just find yourself printing course forms, printing notes that you might never read, sir, because obviously sometimes they revise curriculums and all. So you just find yourself printing this, printing that, and at the end, just one thing you need. Sometimes you don't even need it at all. So for the first few weeks in school, I really wasted money. I printed and printed. Then I would advise you, ask someone maybe who is a year ahead of you, maybe in 200 level, while you're in 100 level. You could always ask, please, do I need this? Do I really need to print this? The person could guide and direct you and tell you, oh, you don't need to do this, so that you not waste your money. And at the end, you're the one that will be hungry. You'll be calling them and told that you need money. So the third thing I wish I knew is the fact that you going to class early doesn't mean you get a good seat, or you get a seat in the front row or something. I know we are going to class early, you're waking up as early as possible so that you can actually get a good place to sit down. But sometimes you get to class, when you enter the lecture hall, you'd see that, okay, seats are empty. Then you get to a chair that you want to sit down. Next thing, you just see biro on the chair, or you see biro cover, or you see a lipstick, and you're like, okay, let me just dust this off. So you just see somebody come from nowhere. I'm sorry, somebody is there. Somebody is what? Somebody is, I cannot see the person. Like, I came here early to sit down. You're telling me someone that is still in their house is going to sit down here. It's so annoying. Like, it happened to me on several occasions. You get to class and you're like, ah, you're happy that you're there on time. And you just see people putting notebooks on their chair, telling you that somebody is there. It was so annoying. Sometimes, you know, you have to fight. You have to tell them, I'm sorry, oh, me, I'm going to sit down here. Sometimes you just use patience and say, okay, no problem. It's something I might also do for my friend too. So that's also one thing I wish I knew before getting to the Nigerian university. So the fourth thing I wish I knew before getting to the Nigerian university is the fact that not everybody is going to get school hostel. In a federal university in Nigeria, the amount of hostels they have is not equal to the amount of students they have. So getting a hostel, or like everybody getting a hostel, is not possible. There are going to be squatters, there are going to be floaters. For me, I never even tried to ballot for school hostel. Why? Because I know my heart to be broken. I just assumed that I was never going to get into the school hostel. So I just got a private hostel. Some people are lucky. All their years in school, they have gotten school hostels. Fine, praise be to God for them. But people like us, that we can never get our hearts broken. We don't even stress ourselves. We just got private hostels. Some people just stay off campus because that hostel thing is a struggle on its own. You wake up as early as, some people don't sleep at all. Once they open the portal for balloting, you see them there. They're already balloting for hostels and they will not still get it. So why should I give myself heartbreak? I don't even stress it. I just got a private hostel. So the fifth thing I wish I knew before getting into the Nigerian university is the fact that my first semester's result in the university might not be the best, or it might not be what I expected. I really wish someone told me this, because a lot of things happen. You're getting used to a new environment, you're getting used to a large class. Some people, maybe in their secondary schools, they were just maybe 20 in the class. Then you get into the Nigerian university and you're seeing like 400 plus people in one class. So a lot of people are getting used to some things. Your stress level is going to increase because you're not having classes in the same place. You're running from one lecture theater to another. Before you get back to your hostel, you are tired. So I really wish I prepared for this. I think if I knew this beforehand, I would have found better ways to go about things. So I really want people to know the fact that your first semester result, it might not be the best. But thanks be to God, we have two semesters. So your second semester, you have to put in the work, put in your so much effort, so that like at the end the cumulative results would be better. For me, my first semester results, it wasn't bad, but it wasn't the best. It wasn't what I wanted. When I saw it, I was like, madam, you have to sit up. This is not what we came to do. So the second semester, like, I was already used to the system. I was used to waking up very early. I was used to the large number of people in class. So that second semester, I immediately knew that, okay, see, once this is not happening, I have to do this. I have to buckle up and really, really try my best. And when I saw my results, my second semester results, it was really better than the first semester result. But you know, we have to divide, add, subtract, minus. So it came down a bit. But I wish I put in, like, I wish I knew the fact that first semester, things are going to be happening. If I was prepared for that, I'm sure my results would have been far, far better than what it was. So I'm telling you now that your first semester results might not be what you wanted to be, but try your best, put in so much effort. God's got you, you're going to be good. So the sixth thing I wish I knew before getting to the Nigerian university is the fact that some of my secondary school teachers liked me. You remember in secondary school, and you were supposed to do a topic or something, and your teacher would be like, don't worry, when you get to the university, this is for the university level. Those people, na scam. Because when you get to the university and you're supposed to do that same topic, the lecturer will be like, I'm sure your secondary school teacher already taught you this. And I'm like, are we a joke to you? What's that? The secondary school teacher is telling me we'll do it in the university. University lecturer is telling me you have done it in secondary school. It's always so annoying, and this happens in some subjects, not everything though, but this happened to me particularly in physics. I think the seventh thing I wish I knew before getting into the Nigerian university is the fact that I should not forget all the things they taught me in secondary school. That la cram, la poor, la forgetting. Don't do it. It's not help you. Don't. Because most things you did in secondary school, you would still redo them again in your first year in the university. Especially for those who are going to be in the science and medical fields. All those physics, chemistry, all those mathematical formulas. Please, don't forget them. You would still use them. Once you know you don't forget, you don't have to overread. But once you forget, and you're like me, that I forgot, I used to eat eba. I had to start reading from the beginning again. So I wish I really knew this. I wish someone told me. Okay, people actually told me, but I wish I was serious about it. I was thinking, university, new person, nothing of secondary school again, but I was shocked. The eighth thing I wish I knew before getting to the university is the fact that not everyone would go for their matriculation ceremony. I personally, I didn't go into the hall that day for the swearing of oaths and all. I was in my room throughout. The only thing I did was I wore my gown, I wore a dress, and I took pictures. And that was because my mom specifically requested for it. If not for that woman, I don't think I would have done anything on that day. And immediately after pictures, I removed the clothes. And I stepped out. Okay, I went to a friend's place. I came back, I ate, I slept, and I got ready for tests. Because we had tests like the next day or the next week, if I remember well. So I didn't go. And I always, like before getting to the university, I always felt I was going to go for my matric. I was going to wear a gown, this, but I didn't go. So this brings me to the ninth point, which is the fact that you cannot skip classes every day. It doesn't work that way, Oremi. Cooking work, very. It doesn't. Before you'd be eligible to write an exam at the end of the semester, you have to have at least 70% attendance. I don't know if this works in every school, but in my school, you need to have 70% of attendance. If you don't have that, you won't be able to write exams because you didn't come to class. So what do you want to come and write? So I used to feel that in the university, I'm the queen, I'm the king, I don't have to go to class. But coming in here, that mentality was washed down the drain. You need to go to class. You have to attend classes. You need the attendance. You cannot just sit down in your hostel and say you're not going to school. Your parents sent you to the university to go to school, to go and read, to attend classes, not to just sit down. So at the end of it all, you need to attend classes. You cannot skip classes. The final point I'm going to be making today is that when coming into the university, you should come with the mindset that everybody is different. You're going to be meeting people from different walks of life, people from different backgrounds, people with different ideologies. They will not think the way you do. They will not act the way you do. You just liken the university to a marketplace. In the marketplace, you're going to be meeting with the market women. You're going to be meeting with the people that would carry load for you. You're going to be meeting with the agberos that will be making noise and all, that will be destroying things there. So you just come in with the mindset that everybody is different. They will not act the way you do. Nobody would speak the way you do. Nobody would, you get, like, everybody is just different. So when coming in, you come into the university knowing that your patience level is increasing, the way you tolerate people is also increasing, the way you would speak to people, you get, is going to be different because you're meeting different people. Some people would speak to you in a way that you can't accept it. Some people would act and you'd be like, what exactly was going through your mind? But just know that I'm telling you now, I'm just giving you this small advice that have the mindset that everybody is different and you love every person with the love of God.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like and subscribe and share this video with your friend, your family, your dad, your mom, sisters, brothers, aunties, uncles, best friends. Thank you so much. I love you all and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. It's okay, please, I want to start. So the ninth thing on my list, aeroplane.